addition to that, the father can get arrested and sent to prison for hurting and abusing people. Abusing and hurting people also happens when a person is drunk. When drunk, people can be quite riotous, which can lead to multiple drunken people starting riots. Also, as CliffNotes.com said, the alcohol abuse contributes to the abuse of women and children. As well as the fact when children grow up while being abused by a drunken parent, it sets a bad example for them. Drunkenness is a bad moral example for children and the populace. Once addicted, people will start drinking and are not able to stop. Once addicted, it's too late to go back. Children, authors of children books even started putting pictures of the evils of drunkenness in their books to purchase alcohol. Though so far, I've only shown one side of the argument, I will not show you the other side. People who do not want to stop the alcohol trade say that it is the buyer's choice if they want to drink and get drunk. This is true, but in a family, if one person chooses to get drunk, the whole family might be put in poverty. That is true, but if this is not fair because only one person chose to get drunk, yet the whole family falls into poverty because one person had a tiny bit and got away. Other people say a little is okay, which is true, but once you have a little, you want more and more. And then before you know it, you're spending more money to get more alcohol, which makes you more drunk. Thus, even though it is the buyer's choice and a little is okay, they will soon get addicted. I will restate again. It is okay to have a tiny bit, but if someone gets drunk and addicted and goes and starts riots, then it becomes more serious. Therefore, if we keep letting people be thrown into poverty, malice, and abuse, the world will probably fall apart. So why should we keep alcohol available to everyone? Thank you. I hope you'll agree with me that we should change.